Good evening and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream. We pray that you are in good health. Although we do not require the use of Vax Pass for worship, we encourage all parishioners to be fully vaccinated, to obtain your Vax Pass, and to follow all the guidelines requested by the health authorities. We ask that all present respect the guidelines we have here at the Basilica to prevent the spread of COVID-19, including using hand sanitizers, refraining from congregational singing, maintaining a distance of 2 meters, and wearing face masks at all times in the church. We will not have a collection at this Mass, but there are collection boxes provided for you at the entrance and the exit of the church. Your donations pay for the utilities and salaries of the parish. Thank you for supporting our Basilica parish. At the time of communion, we will give you further instructions, and at the end of Mass, we ask you to follow the usher's directions for leaving the church. Thank you. Our opening hymn this evening, 531, For the Beauty of the Earth, in the Catholic Book of Worship, and our presider this evening is Father Cecil Critch. Kindly stand. Sound and sight, Lord of all, to you we raise this our hymn of grateful praise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good evening, everyone. Today in our scriptures, we learn about love, love of God and love of our neighbor. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries today, we ask the Lord to come into our hearts and to forgive us from the times we have failed to love others as we should. We ask the Lord's forgiveness.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, "May you and your children and your children's children fear the Lord your God all the days of your life, and keep all his decrees and his commandments that I am commanding you, so that your days may be long. Hear therefore, O Israel, and observe them diligently, so that it may go well with you, so that you may multiply greatly in a land flowing with milk and honey, as the Lord, the God of your fathers, has promised you. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, "I love you, O Lord, my strength." I love you, O Lord, my strength.
I love you, O Lord, my strength.
I love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God, my rock in whom I take refuge. My shield and the source of my salvation, my stronghold. I love you, Lord, my strength. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. shall be saved from my enemies. From his temple he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears. I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord lives, blessed be my rock, and exalted be the God of my salvation. Great triumphs he gives to his king, and shows steadfast love to his anointed. I love you, Lord, my
strength. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The priests of the first covenant were many in number because they were prevented by death from continuing in office. But Jesus holds his priesthood permanently because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able for all time to save those who approach God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. For it was fitting that we should have been such a high priest, holy, blameless, undefiled, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. Unlike the other high priests, he has no need to offer sacrifices day after day, first for his own sins, and then for those of the people. For this he did once for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints as high priests those who are subject to weakness, but the word of the oath, which came later than the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. One of the scribes came near and heard the religious authorities disputing with one another, and seeing that Jesus answered them well, he asked him, "Which commandment is the first of all?" And Jesus answered, "The first is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, that you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." And then the scribe said to him, "You are right, teacher. You have truly said that he is one, and besides him there is no other. To love him with all the heart and with all the understanding and with all the strength, and to love one's neighbor as oneself. This is much more important than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices. When Jesus saw that the scribe answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." After that, no one dared to ask Jesus any question. The Gospel of the Lord. The law of the Old Testament, the Jewish scriptures, consisted of some 613 commandments found in the Torah, the book of the law. The Pentateuch, we call it, the first five books of the Hebrew Bible, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. They're the first five. These five books make up the story of the Jewish people, and running through these five books is the unique lens through which the Jewish people would come to view their world and their God. Most of these 613 laws covering every aspect of Jewish life are found in Deuteronomy and Leviticus, those two books. The scribe's question in the gospel today as to which of these laws was the greatest would have been frequently discussed among the rabbis. And Jesus was asked to name the greatest commandment. But Jesus named two, which he determined were inseparable. The first is called the Shema in Deuteronomy 6, verse 4. The command states, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord God is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and all your mind." And this prayer called the Shema because the Hebrew word Shema means listen or hear. The Shema is the centerpiece of daily morning and evening prayer services and is considered by some the most essential prayer in all Judaism and traditionally a Jewish person's last words before death. Jesus and the apostles would have said this prayer many times because they were Jewish, since its daily recitation is regarded by traditionalists as a biblical commandment. So it is recited with the hand placed over the eyes, covering the eyes. The importance of this prayer in the Jewish law is seen in the advisory in Deuteronomy that comes after. It says, "Take to heart these instructions which I in charge on you this day, impress them upon your children. Recite them when you stay at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you get up. Bind them as a sign in your hand, and let them serve as a symbol on your forehead. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates." And in traditional Judaism, you sometimes see people, they wear little boxes right there on their forehead and on their arms. And inside those little, and on the lintels of the houses, and this prayer, the Shema, is in there. That's how important. But Jesus gave the second commandment as well. But that's not in the same book. It's in the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 18. "You must love your neighbor as yourself." This commandment in Leviticus, to love our neighbor, was restricted to fellow Jews, interpreted in this commandment as the neighbor being only Jewish people. What Jesus was put these two commandments together, emphasizing that love of God is interwoven with love for your neighbor. And of course, after this particular piece of gospel, he asks, "Who is my neighbor?" And then, of course, we go into the Good Samaritan, you see? The person who was the stranger, the Gentile, the Samaritan, which means that everyone is your neighbor. So Jesus changes that commandment in Judaism. Any claim to love God is empty if it does not result in loving other people, reaching out to embrace them as God does. There is really only one commandment then, the commandment to love God and love your neighbor, the commandment to love. And that's how we will be judged. It is impossible to have one without the other. The commandment to love God and your neighbor would become the identifying characteristic of the Christian religion. Failure to love then is the greatest failure in a Christian person. The worst sin of omission is a lack of love for others or, at worst, cold indifference to their needs. How many times have we heard, even among divided families, that after a family member dies, realize they left it too late to reach out in love, to forgive, to heal the broken relationships, to reconcile, and now they are full of regrets. We often wait until it's too late to tell others that we love them, to make peace with them, to reconcile with them. Jesus went straight to the heart of what constitutes true worship and guidelines for true Christian living. Love is above sacrifice. love is above ritual. To love God and love your neighbor as yourself. That is the essence of our Christian religion, because we cannot separate religion from life. Religion is not a private matter for Christians between a person and God. We hear that often. There is the important other side of the coin. We were baptized into a community, and we are all journeying on this faith journey together. To say our prayers and attend Sunday Mass while ignoring the cries of our neighbor in need is a mere half-hearted response to God's love. The great danger facing church-going people is they often do not see the connection between what they do in church on a Sunday or Saturday and what they do in relation to their neighbor the rest of the week. Religion for some people is often divorced from life. Today we're asked to reflect on the quality of love in our lives. Love is far more than some cozy sentimental feeling that happens between family and friends, but the love Jesus is talking about means to go beyond the person, to rise above our own needs, to reach out to someone in need. The neighbor Jesus is talking about also means the person whom we dislike, the one that irritates us. We are called to love others in a practical way, and we have in Matthew the answer: visiting the sick, feeding the poor, visiting the prisoners, caring for the elderly, welcoming the stranger, comforting the bereaved. All these little acts of kindness we do for others, no matter how great or small, that's love. It's about dying to our own selfishness and rising in the ways of compassion and mercy that Jesus taught us to do. That is the type of sacrificial love that Jesus wants us to imitate, to lay down our lives in love for other people. When the love of God and the love of neighbor are evident in this way, that's where the kingdom of God is proclaimed. So Jesus is saying that it is our loving relationship with God, first of all, loving God with our heart and soul and mind and strength, which will empower us and give us the courage and strength to love our neighbor, even our enemies. A prayer that captures something of this all-embracing love of God that Jesus calls for in the first commandment and gives us the courage and strength to love our neighbor in the second part of that commandment, I think, is by St. Ignatius of Loyola, the founder of the Jesuits. And St. Ignatius of Loyola had a strong sense of how much he had received from God and the desire to give it all back to God. And this comes through in his prayer, and I'll quote his prayer and I'll end with his prayer. He says, "Take, Lord, and receive all my liberty, my memory, my understanding, all my will, all that I have and possess. You, Lord, have given all to me. I now give it back to you. Amen." We pray together our creed, what we believe as Christians. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We turn now in prayer to our Heavenly Father, trusting in God's merciful help for us.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Peter, our Archbishop, that they may have the strength and courage to lead and guide the people of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Archdiocese, as we journey through the process of restructuring, that we trust in the Holy Spirit, who will be with us and will help us in the challenges and decisions we face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Synod of Bishops process in our Archdiocese, that the Holy Spirit may be with us as we read the signs of the time and journey into the future with the Church, the people of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of healing and reconciliation for our Indigenous sisters and brothers who experience suffering at residential schools, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may continue to bless and accompany the participants of the Alpha and Discovery Faith programs, that they all may draw closer to Jesus and invite Him to be the center of their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that all countries commit to efforts to combat climate change and to show respect for our earth, God's creation, our common home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, that the healing power of the Holy Spirit may be upon them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have recently died, we pray for Jita Penny, Michael Keane, and for all who mourn the death of loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for the quiet prayers, the quiet of your heart, your own intentions for this Mass. We pray to the Lord. God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the graces and blessings you give us every day. And we make our prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Joy may be yours, and that your joy.
and you shall be blessed, and you shall be blessed.
And pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. And he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and yet you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We are praying the fourth Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. And therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our bishop, with all the bishops, priests, and deacons, religious, and the entire people, you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspiring us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face and in the resurrection. Give them the fullness of life. Grant also thus to us that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place with you forever. And there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. John the Baptist, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And we pray with confidence to our Heavenly Father in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, I said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And we share the peace of Christ now with one another.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
A prayer for those who are unable to receive Holy Communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. To ensure that the reception of Holy Communion takes place in a safe and respectful manner, we ask that you please follow these instructions. Instead of individually replying Amen upon receiving the host, there will be one general attestation of Amen before distribution begins. Please remain standing in your pew until invited forward by an usher. Ensure your face mask is correctly worn before coming forward, and maintain a 2-meter social distance in the communion line. As you approach the front of the line, sanitize your hands before receiving communion. Bow towards the host. In silence, receive the host in your hands. Step aside to consume the host. Return to your pew as directed by ushers. Those unable to receive Holy Communion in the hand may come forward to receive a blessing.
In the body of Christ.
Our communion hymn 6.6 in the celebrating song, One Love Released. One bread, one body, one cup, one One faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. Is not this bread we share the body of our Lord? Is not this wine we drink the blood of Christ outpoured? One bread, one body, one cup, one cord. One faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. I am the bread of life, eat and you shall live. To those who share this meal, my strength I'll always give. One bread, one body, one cup, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. I am the living bread, as manna from the sky. This bread I give to you, that you may never die. One bread, one body, one cup, one core.
and in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released.
Just a couple of announcements to highlight from the bulletin. Today, you can pick up a copy. This week, of course, Monday is All Saints Day. All Hallows, we call it, All Saints. And so we'll be two masses for those who are working during the day, get a chance at night. So on Monday, we have a mass at 9 o'clock a.m. And 7 o'clock in the evening. So it'll be two masses for All Saints. Tuesday for All Souls, there will be two masses, 9 a.m. and 7 p.m. For All Souls Day, where we mark all those who have died this past year and all of our loved ones who have died in our parish and also wherever all of you come from. We just pray for all of our souls. Just a reminder, if you are a Mon student, Mass will be at Memorial on Wednesdays at 12:15, and you can find the information in the bulletin. Next Saturday, the first Saturday, is our Adoration Night, so from 7 o'clock to 9, join us for Eucharistic Adoration, praise and worship music, and confessions will be available as well, and a benediction will end the evening at 8:45. So, very good. Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift of receiving what they promise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for all your presence here today, for all those who ministered to us and with us today. Bernie in the sacristy here helps out a lot. We have Brenda, Max Collett down there, and John and Kay Barrington, who are leading us in our ushers on Saturday, and of course during the week we have many ushers that help us to keep everything safe for us during this pandemic, especially. I thank Rudy and Alma, Rudy for reading, and Alma for the music, and Patty as well. So thank you for all of your gifts and talents that we use, so many people use in our parish. So thank everyone. God bless. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of us, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Let us be to God.
Have a great day.
You too, Father. Our missioning hymn this evening, 625 in the CBW, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. 625. Love divine, all loves excelling, joy of heaven to earth come down. Fix in us your humble dwelling, all your faithful mercies crown. Jesus, you are all compassion, boundless love that makes us whole. Visit us with your salvation. Enter every trembling soul.